First of all, I like to wish a very prosperous and happy New Year 2023. I hope everyone will enjoy this 2023 and will grow to the level best and use your intuition, smart and intelligent brain and power, and also the luck that is going to show in this 2023. What changes that you can expect in this 2023? What are the planetary positions that will take and transit to other sign and that will impact our whole life? In general, it is very rare to see all the nine planets changing its direction and going to other moon sign, means the transit happening in this year 2023. All the nine planets. It is very, very rare. So you will observe a very drastic changes in terms of career, finance, wealth and relationship and other things also. So I'm going to discuss all these things in a very simple way so that it is visible and understood by all of you with ease. First of all, this prediction will be based on the moon sign. The moon sign, because the moon sign is as per the Vedic astrology, not as per the Western astrology. And sun sign is a different prediction. So now, if you are using your moon sign or the ascendant, suppose I am explaining the Aries moon sign and Aries ascendant, then 100% accuracy can be obtained for ascendant people, and 90-95% accuracy can be obtained based on the planetary position on your horoscope for the Aries sign, Aries moon sign. So like that, I will be trying to discuss all the 12 signs from Aries to Pisces and that planetary position also. First of all, you must know that what are the position of the current planets, then I'll go up one by one. Om Ganeshaya Namah, Bhagavan Shri Chattasabhaya Namah, Suryaya Namah, Shanishraya Namah. Happy New Year to all people, all the viewers that is watching this video. If you have not subscribed to my channel yet, then I would request you to subscribe it on the occasion of this New Year video and like and share with your friends too. First of all, on January 17th, 2023, in evening 5 p.m. approx, Saturn, the Shani planet, will be transiting to other sign, means from Capricorn moon sign to Aquarius. So this will have a very big impact. Then on 22nd of April, Jupiter will transit from its own sign, means the Pisces, to Aries. And it will have a Guru Chandal yoke also from 22nd to 30th October 2023. And on 38th October evening, Rahu is going to transit to Pisces and Ketu is going to transit on Virgo moon sign respectively. So this is the big four planet major changes that you will witness. Apart from that, in every 40 to 45 days, Mars will have the transit. In every 15 to 20 days, the Mercury will transit. Every month, Sun will have the transit. In every 2.5 days, Moon will transit. So in this way, you will witness the power of the sign that will be changing one after the another. So I am going to discuss one by one. Please stay tuned till the end of the video, so that you can also get benefited from the remedies that I will be giving you to maximize the power and bring more wealth, prosperity, happiness to this 2023 and how to utilize that. Gemini moon sign. First of all, you need to know that Saturn is on your 8th house right now, and most of the relaxation you will be able to get when Saturn will be moving to your 9th house on January 17th evening. So Saturn will be moving to your Aquarius moon sign from Capricorn, and it will give you a very, very positive chance and brings lots of luck and fortune to you. As 9th house is related to fate and fortune and the luck house, so luck which you have not expected, and you want to pursue some dream, ambitions to be fulfilled, all the things will happen. And what about the things that is going quite slow from the last few years, that will be removed. You will definitely be able to find something new in your business, something new in your job, where you will be able to go to the next level in terms of business also. So lots of positive change you can expect in this 2023, because Saturn will also have the impact to your 11th house, which is your gain house, and also in your third house. So lots of changes you can expect because of the Saturn will be moving to the Multricon moon sign, which is Aquarius. And Saturn will have a very positive movement, but you still need to check whether Saturn is positive in your horoscope or not. If Saturn is positive to your horoscope, then it is well and good, and it will give you lots of changes and positive impact on this 2023. Next, Ketu and Rahu. Ketu is in your 5th house and Rahu is in your 11th house from April 2022. And for the whole year till October 38, 2023, Rahu will be in your 11th house and Ketu will be in your 5th house. As this 2023 will be the Ketu year as per numerology, so that from your moon sign, Ketu is in your 5th house. So lots of spiritual development, family guidance, you will be able to find some guru or master in your life. Although you are very intelligent and smart by nature, but you will be able to maximize your intelligence in this 2023 much more, because the Saturn will also impact to your 11th house, which is along with the Rahu. So this is a positive chance, but stay away from bigger investment more than your capability. I know you are very much capable, you are a very good confident person, but sometimes confidence is not that much high because of Mercury. But if your Mercury is good, then definitely you are very, very confident and you are always successful in your life because of the placement of the other planets. Now you need to check the placement of the Jupiter also in your horoscope. As already Jupiter is in your 10th house right now and it will be moving to your 11th house on April 22nd, 2023. So in that way the Rahu and Jupiter will be together and the Guru Chandra Yoga will be forming. But still it is in your 11th house and it will be in the benefic house. And that is one of the reasons that you will be able to maximize the power of the Jupiter and Rahu. But as the Guru Chandal forming, those will be forming, so you need to be careful. Careful in the sense that what you need to do and what you are doing, don't say to other people before completion of the work. Or before starting any work, don't say anything. You can inform your parents or partner, that is okay, but not to other people, because people are always jealous of you. What you do, what you want to do. So there are lots of things that will be involved. And that is the reason that you need to make your Saturn and Venus stronger at the same time, along with Rahu. So if you are trying to go to foreign country, which is not developing or which is not happening, definitely in this period, you will be able to go. You will be able to see lots of good growth in this 2023 because of the placement, and definitely things will be very good for you. It is one of the biggest changes that you will witness, but try to be very sure that you can do it. Don't feel that you cannot do it, because you have a good capability of doing things. You'll be able to see major changes because of your decision-making power. Health issues in terms of joint pains can be a problem for you. Other than that, little bit of digestion problem will come, but not much more. Try to do the remedies that I'm going to give you so that it is also beneficial for you. If you want to consult me, then you can definitely do it by making the payment. Paid consultation will give you more accuracy to the as per the ascendant and the moon sign. I'm not saying that you should consult me only, you can do with any astrologer. Try to do the remedies. If blue sapphire is favorable for you, definitely you should wear it as per the ascendant. But before that, you should definitely consult an astrologer so that blue sapphire is favorable for you or not. If Venus is very strong and placement is good, then nothing to do about the Venus. But always try to chant the mantras for Shani, means the Saturn. Om Pram Prem Prat Shani Shraya Namo Om Shani Chalisa, at least one time in the evening, and Hanuman Chalisa in the morning. So that will remove the obstacle, hurdles, and it will bring you positivity, give you success in your life. So this is all about the Gemini moon sign as per your Vedic astrology. If you have not subscribed to my channel yet, then I request you to subscribe it, like it, and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you always get the future notification of my videos. Stay happy, stay fit, love all, serve all, Radhe Radhe.